The interface between officials from the Ministry of Agriculture and the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament follows a query raised in the December 2023 Auditor General's report that queried the 15 billion shilling goat rollout project implemented in seven districts. The Ministry of Agriculture procured 2,902 local indigenous goats worth 1.156 billion shillings and imported 71 goats at a cost of 528 million shillings. Members of the Public Accounts Committee were shocked on discovering that each of the imported goats cost 7.4 billion shillings.
It's very important, Mr. Chairman, to understand that if goat costs about at 7 million, must have far extreme benefits that this country would actually benefit, and it was thought well, and the cost-benefit analysis was done, in comparison, the record goats being bought at 300,000.
Stephen Kajura, the project coordinator at the Ministry of Agriculture, defended the high cost spent on each goat, noting that some of them were imported into the country in order to improve the local breeds.
But this one of 7.4 million per goat is something that I wanted to be explained how it was sourced and eventually purchased at that cost.
Sanan goat from South Africa and Namibia. We bought a high pedigree animal, and this cost includes cost insurance and freight. So it came to 7.4 million. The exotic goats we bought are high pedigree goats that are supposed to improve the blood of. So pedigree animals are usually very expensive.
According to the Auditor General, all of the 150 goats distributed in Nakasongola District worth 52.5 million shillings had died, whereas in Gomba District, out of the 700 goats distributed worth 245 million shillings, 259 goats worth 90.7 million shillings had died. This indicates that a total of 409 goats out of 850 distributed in Gomba and Nakasongola Districts worth 143 million shillings had died by the time of audit in September 2023.
You should note that it's a serious issue. First week of delivery, Mr. Chairman, that's when the goats died.
The goats, for example, died in the very first week. Anybody would be interested to know this, is it as a result of disease or as a result of a felony on the other side of the supplier.
The Public Accounts Committee also discovered that the contractor supplied sick and emaciated goats to the government, which contributed to the 48% mortality rate.
You pick goats from wherever you got them from, very sick, coughing, sneezing. They had every kind of sickness. Then you give them to farmers.
Sembeguya Estates Uganda Limited, the contractor who got the deal to supply goats, was supposed to isolate, vaccinate, tag and distribute the goats, but MPs established that the goats were not vaccinated. The committee queried circumstances under which Sembeguya Estates was contracted without a competitive bidding.
I would plea for you, if it will be procedure okay, for the accounting officer to direct one of his officers to go back in office and bring to us the contract and the procedures they followed in appointing Mr. Sembeguya to provide goats. Why I'm insisting on this? This man appeared before this committee.
I really recognize and applaud the enthusiasm of questioning Sembeguya and his the way we appointed, the way we contracted him. And I pledge, sir.
David Kasura Chomukama, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture, said most of the queries highlighted by the committee were also discovered by the ministry, which consequently discontinued the project.
This is an audit for 22-23. For 23-24, I can assure you we have not budgeted for this activity, for this project.
Why?
Because of the issues, we took proactive action. And okay. Noted most of the issues that you are talking about.
Chomukama asked the Public Accounts Committee to give the ministry more time to provide responses to the questions raised by the MPs regarding the controversial procurement.
Noted there are two issues. One, how did we get Sembeguya? Who is he and how did we get him? Two, having got him wherever, however we got him, the goats that he gave us.
I believe, sir, you have a big case at hand. And we are talking about, you have even confirmed, you yourself, you are not willing to continue with the project.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.